I'm Jordan Miner for PCMag.com, and this is Games To Go. Today we're looking at Final Fantasy VII on the iPad. Now, Final Fantasy VII is a very important game. When it came out on the PlayStation 1 about 20 years ago, it was the first time the series had been in 3D. It was the first in the series that kind of moved from a medieval style to a more kind of sci-fi steampunk style. And it just hit a generation of gamers like at just the right time. Like, it's very beloved, and it's still very beloved.
Final Fantasy VII is the catcher in the rye of video games.
And this is pretty much that same game. If you're expecting kind of high-end graphics, you'll have to wait for the remake coming out in a few years. But this is the same game with the same kind of chunky, like super deformed art style. Aerith still dies. You still play as Cloud Strife and like these freedom fighters. Sephiroth still has that long big sword. There's still Barret and his weird gun hands and kind of casual racism. But on the iPad, obviously things have to be a little different. On PlayStation 1, you had a controller, and on the iPad, you just have a touchscreen. And what they've done here, I think, is kind of like lazy. To compensate, they've just kind of slapped virtual buttons on the screen. And a lot of early iOS games did that because they couldn't figure out how to make games that were designed for the touchscreen. But we've gotten away from that now because we realize that's not a good way to play games. And Final Fantasy VII on the iPad just does that. There are these just kind of ugly, transparent buttons on the screen. And now that kind of works for an RPG like this because it's slower paced, but it's just annoying. And it clashes with other menu elements. You don't know what things that you can touch and what things you're going to have to scroll through. In addition, but this is a good addition, you can turn off random encounters. Like, one of the worst aspects, to me at least, of RPGs is having to grind your way through enemies that just show up randomly. And here you can just turn that off. Now, when you do turn that off, you won't gain experience the same way you normally do, so you won't be strong enough to fight some of the enemies, but you can turn them back on when you need to kind of level up again. Also, if you just want to really breeze through the game, you can, at any point, put all your stats to maximum. You'll have maximum strength, maximum health, all that. Now, you're kind of really cheating, but it's cool that that option's there. I'm gonna kill these guys like immediately though, because I'm so over-leveled. Final Fantasy VII on the iPad, it's $15.99, which is really expensive, but most Square Enix games on the App Store cost that much. But compared to something like The World Ends With You, which was like a reimagining of that game, I took advantage of the iPad control scheme, I think Final Fantasy VII is a little disappointing, but the core game is still quite good. You can tell why people really like it still. So I give it 4 out of 5 stars. You can check out the review on PCMag.com.